नमस्कार, प्रणाम, जय हिंद। मैं अपरायता राज आपको फिर से आपका स्वागत करती हूँ डैट थिंक लैब्स के नेक्स्ट इस सेशन में। सो एज यू नो, एग्जाम्स काफ़ी नियर हो चुके हैं, दिन ब दिन प्रेशर बढ़ते जा रहा है, आपके पास बहुत सारे समय कम है, इसीलिए हम लोग बहुत छोटे छोटे वीडियोज आपके लिए बना रहे हैं जो आपको लास्ट मिनट में थोड़ा हेल्प करें। आज हम लोग बात करेंगे idioms एंड phrases पे एंड वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन पे। idioms एंड phrases को अगर समझना है तो इसके लिए सब एक ही तरीका है, एक ही तरीका है इज टू एक्चुअली रीड एज मेनी एज पॉसिबल idioms एंड phrases ऑनलाइन। उनको आप पढ़ते रहिए, बुक से पढ़ते रहिए, जहाँ से भी, और उनके मीनिंग्स को आप पढ़िए लिखिए। आपके पास एग्जामिनेशन इसका कोई ट्रिक नहीं है, देयर इज नो ट्रिक एज सच कि आप इसको मतलब ऐसे जल्दी सॉल्व कर सकते हैं। आप वो फ्रेज पढ़े एग्जाम में, idiom पढ़े, और आपको उसका आंसर पता होना चाहिए कि ये मतलब ABC में से कन्फ्यूजन होना ही नहीं चाहिए कि क्या इसका आंसर होगा। तो जस्ट कीप रीडिंग देम एंड राइटिंग देम इन योर नोटबुक एंड रिपीटेडली। आज 10 idiom 10 फ्रेज लिखें, अभी उसको दोबारा 2 घंटे बाद 3 घंटे बाद फिर से लिख लीजिए, और अगर लिख भी नहीं रहे तो एटलीस्ट एक बार पढ़ लीजिए। तो कीप रिपीटिंग देम, रिवाइजिंग देम, देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू लाइक, वो आपके दिमाग में बैठे रहेंगे, और देयर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ देम, वी हैव लेस टाइम, सो फोकस ऑन एज मेनी एज पॉसिबल। छोटे छोटे idioms आते हैं, छोटे छोटे फ्रेजेस आते हैं, तो यू कैन डू इट डेफिनेटली। लेट्स डू अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस ओवर हियर, जो टेस्ट सीरीज से ही डैट के जो टेस्ट सीरीज पब्लिश है उसी में से मैंने लिया है। सो देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन, यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रीड इट केयरफुली। The question, in each of the following questions, choose the alternative which best expresses the meaning of the idiom printed in bold. जो bold में idiom print है उसका 4 option दिया हुआ है, उसमें से आपको choose करना जो best उसके expression को explain करता है. Okay? So, the first one is spick and span. इसका meaning होता है, अब इसमें option क्या है? Neat and clean, outspoken, a ready-made thing, galerous. एक्चुअली इसका मीनिंग है नीट एंड क्लीन, स्पिक एंड द रूम इज स्पिक एंड स्पैन, स्पैन द रूम इज नीट एंड क्लीन। द नेक्स्ट idiom इज टू शो वंस टीथ, टू शो वंस टीथ इज बेसिकली टू शो सम एग्रेसिव बिहेवियर, जैसे हाउ द डॉग्स डू इट व्हेन दे आर एंग्री, दे करके दांत दिखाते हुए करते हैं, द सेम वे इट्स लाइक समथिंग क्लोज टू इट। ओके, टू शो वंस टीथ, A, to ridicule, no. B, to face difficulties, no. To adopt a threatening attitude, sounds a yes to me. To be humble, no. So the answer is C, to adopt a threatening attitude. Question number 60, next question is, to see red. To see red is again to be very angry, get aggressive, like something that boils you down. If something happens and it makes you really angry. So the option A is, to be very angry, it seems this is the answer as for me. To victimize someone, no. To find faults with, no. To criticize others, no. The answer is A, to be very angry. Okay, now if we go to other idioms, it's in another test series, I'm picking the idioms from there. Okay, the next idiom is pin money. Pin money is basically money given to spend on something essential. Like if some money is given to someone to spend on their essential things, it's not for entertainment or time pass or something like that. So the option is bribery. A is bribery. No, it is bribery is given against a favor. Generally, it's a wrong thing. You should not do it. By the way, okay. B is money paid for compensation. Again, compensation is something which is paid against, maybe for against an injury, against a loss. Against an injury, against a loss, something like that. So it's not compensation. Alimony, it is also against, like when you are divorced, it is against like the part of the divorce part when you have, like you are given money against something. It is that. Allowance made to a lady for her expenses. So this is the correct answer. If an allowance is given to a lady to spend on her expenses, which is going to be her essential things, then obviously it is called pin money. So option answer is D. Next idiom is a green horn. A green horn you can connect to is like a new, something new. Like when animals get a horn on their head, they generally come out in something very greenish. They are initially they are kind of soft and they are green. Like you can connect to a bud of a flower. Okay. जो फूल की छोटे से कली होती है वो हरे रंग की शुरू में होती है फिर वो खिलता है, राइट? सो इट्स समथिंग कली के नहीं हुई. वैसे अ ग्रीन हॉर्न इज ऑल्सो समथिंग न्यू विच इज कमिंग अपकमिंग न्यू विच हैज जस्ट स्टार्टेड. सो द ऑप्शंस आर एनवियस लेडी, नो. अ ट्रेनी, नो. एन इनएक्सपीरियंस्ड मैन, इट साउंड्स यस टू मी. डी अ सॉफ्ट हार्टेड मैन, no. So the answer is C, an inexperienced man, a man who has no experience, who is new to something, right? Who doesn't have experience to some subject, some topic. He is new to it. So obviously the meaning for a greenhorn is an inexperienced man. Number 66, to cut the crackle. I have been knowing the meaning of this crackle around, like you are cracking a joke and something like, it's about crackling is basically a general casual attitude or something like that. To cut the crackle actually means to stop being like all the wrong, like non-unrequired things. So let's go to the options. To agree, no. To stare fixedly, no. To be angry, no. To stop talking nonsense. Actually, this means that to stop talking nonsense or to stop an act which is done without any sense, without any meaning. Okay, so to stop talking nonsense is the answer, which is option D. So, and let's come to, this is the idioms and phrases. I'm giving you some example. These questions, I'm not explaining here something out of this world. You actually have to understand the meaning. You have to learn the meaning of all these idioms on yourself. So that aap isko examination hall mein सॉल्व कर सकते हो. मैं बस आपको थोड़ा सा यहाँ पे हेल्प करी. एक तो मैं आंसर्स दे रही हूँ इस टेस्ट सीरीज का, एंड आई एम ट्राइंग टू हेल्प यू आउट कि किस तरह से कनेक्ट आप कर सकते हो इडियम्स एंड फ्रेजेस से. इडियम्स एंड फ्रेजेस को आप याद करते समय भी, जैसे कि मैंने अभी कहा पिन मनीज ऑब्वियसली फॉर एसेंशियल्स, तो अगर उससे मिलता जुलता कोई भी, अब जैसे यहाँ पे अलायंस मेड टू अ लेडी फॉर हर एक्सपेंसेस, यहाँ पे एसेंशियल नहीं लिखा है, फॉर हर एसेंशियल्स, लेकिन फॉर हर एक्सपेंसेस मतलब दैट्स फॉर हर पर्सनल एक्सपेंसेस, दैट्स कुड बी हर एसेंशियल एक्सपेंसेस. तो आपको वो क्लोजेस्ट मीनिंग समझना है. सो एक बार आप मीनिंग समझ लेंगे, उसके बाद आपको उसमें से ऑब्वियसली ऑप्शंस में से जो सही आंसर है वो आपको मिल जाएगा. थोड़ा सा कोशिश करना होगा आंसर्स याद करने में, मीनिंग्स को याद रखने में. नाउ लेट्स कम टू वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन. ठीक है, एक वर्ड मतलब देयर इज अ सेंटेंस, मोस्टली व्हाट हैपेंस, देयर इज अ सेंटेंस गिवन टू यू और समथिंग related to something, I'm sorry, but एक sentence होगा जिसका आपको एक कोई एक word होगा जो पूरे sentence को represent करेगा. So again here you need to understand the meaning of a word जो उस पूरे sentence को represent कर रहा है, तभी वो sentence आपको पता चलेगा. ठीक है, so let's do a few questions, आपको clarity मिलेगा कि किस तरह के questions आते हैं. The question is on the board, the question is on the screen. In questions given below, out of four alternatives, choose the one which can be substituted for the given word sentence. Okay, so the question is, one who cannot be changed or reformed. Options are invulnerable, invulnerable nahi hoga, incurable, no, incurable is something that cannot be cured, hardened, which is something which is not soft, which obviously you cannot change something which is hardened, you cannot reform it. Next option is incorrigible. Incorrigible is something which means you cannot correct it or reform it. So the closest meaning to that, the word which closest takes substitute the entire sentence, one who cannot be changed or reformed, is actually incorrigible, which is option D. Next question. A low area storm with high winds rotating about a center of low atmospheric pressure is called what? Okay, like is called what is not there in the question. So is it called a cyclone? Yes, a cyclone, as per the definition of cyclone, it is actually inward movement of wind towards low barometric pressure. Okay. B, tornado. Tornado is also kind of a cyclone, but it is huge and it is like a funnel shaped, and it actually occupies in a very small area. It is not like a, it doesn't suit the exact meaning of the word low area storm. It occupies very small region, and tornado moves. Typhoon is a kind of storm, and storm includes rain, thunder, thunderstorm, all those things. So typhoon is again not the word. Hurricane is again a kind of storm which includes violent wind. So no. So the best answer, the closest, is cyclone, option A. Next question, a person living permanently in a certain place. Person who's living permanently, resident, your residence may change. You are a resident of Delhi at present, and you could be a resident of Mumbai maybe next month, and you might have been a resident of Hyderabad a few years before. So your residence keep changing. Native is your belongingness, your family belongingness. So no. Domicile is actually your permanent address. Basically, if you see the word, meaning of word domicile, it's permanent. Subject, no. So the answer is C, domicile. Mania for stealing articles, it is quite a common word, everyone should be knowing it. So hypomania, no. Kleptomania is defined as a mania for stealing articles. So answer is B. Logomania, stellomania, no. So answer is B, kleptomania. Next is one who loves mankind is optimist. Optimist is who's a very positive person. Philanthropist is actually someone who is eager to do something for the mankind because they love mankind. Optometrist, no. Trant, no. So the answer is B, philanthropist. Next question is, a government run by a dictator is termed as autocracy. Yes, if you see the definition of the word autocracy, it is actually a government that is run by a dictator. Democracy is actually a government run by elected people. Okay, oligarchy and theocracy, no. So answer is A, autocracy. So you see here in one word substitution, you actually have to know the meaning of the words, only then you will be able to like relate to that sentence, to that word. Agar aapko words ki meaning pata hai, to aapko wo pata chalega ki acha ye jo one word substitute ho raha hai, ye word isi sentence ke liye suitable hai. So ab aapko one word substitution matlab word ki meaning kaise yaad rakhne hai. ऐसे तो ऑनलाइन और बुक्स में एंड इवन डैट के ऑनलाइन साइट पे बहुत सारे idioms मिलेंगे, phrases मिलेंगे, एंड यू विल गेट lot of sentences फॉर वन वर्ड substitution. ऑल्सो इन सब चीज़ों को आपको सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी होता है लिखना. आप इनको लिखिए, लिख के अगर आप एक बार भी इसे लिखेंगे, ट्रस्ट मी, इट्स गोइंग टू स्टे इन योर माइंड. अभी टाइम कम है, बट लिखिए और उनको एक बार फिर से पढ़िए. राइट इट डाउन इन अ नोटबुक. For example, what was that sentence? Okay, so mania for stealing articles and kleptomania. आपको सही word उस sentence के लिए सही word पता है. You write it down, read it again after few hours, and then maybe you can read it again after few days. So it will be there in your mind. This is the only trick which is going to help you. अभी time कम है, but see as much as you could do. And same goes for the idioms and phrases. You write down the idioms and phrases and their meaning and revise them. So all the very best again. Keep working hard, keep studying smartly, and subscribe, comment, share. And before subscribe, comment, share. If you have any question, any doubt, you want to ask something, you want any video more on about more clarity on any specific subject, please leave your comment below. That team will get back to you. All the very best again. Take care. Namaste. Jai Hind.